Hey guys, it's Yvonne, and in this video I want to show you how to set up the Facebook Ads pixel on your Shopify store manually, because I know some of you guys are unable to install it automatically by simply adding your Facebook pixel ID in Shopify. And so I'm going to show you here how to do it completely manually by going into the coding for Shopify for your theme and adding it there. So let's get straight into it. So I'm going to assume you already set up a pixel. If you haven't, simply go to your events manager here in Facebook Ads and click on connect data sources and then click on web, click on connect, and you should be able to get the Facebook pixel from there. If you already do, as I have here a bunch of different pixel examples, what you can do is click on add events over here for the pixel that you want, and then click on from a new website, and then click on install code manually, and then you should get the pixel code right here that we're gonna need. You will also need to use this website here, conversion tracking. I'm going to put a link to this website here in the description of the video. You can also access it through Facebook. If you go back here, if you click on add events, click on from the pixel, and click on install events using code, you will come across this same website here as well. So you can do that, but we are going to click on add new website, install code manually. So this is the code that we're going to install, okay? We're gonna have to install the code on two different pages. One is for your theme in general, and the other code on your order form confirmation page to actually track the sales. So this is the code. I'm assuming you already have your store set up. So in your store in Shopify, click on themes, and the first thing we're gonna do is click on edit code. And over here, you're gonna click on theme liquid. And this is where we're gonna be adding the code at the top of the head section. So find where it says head over here, click on enter, and we're going to enter our Facebook pixel here. So let's go back to our Facebook event here, copy code, and let's post it on Notepad just so you see the full picture. So the code should look like this. This is your Facebook code. It should have your Facebook pixel ID right here, right here. So as you can see, this is the manual way. With the automatic way, all you're gonna do is put this into Shopify, and then Shopify writes all this automatically for you. But if you wanna do it manually, we have to write all this for Shopify. So we're simply going to copy this. I'm going to Control C to copy. We're gonna come back here and we're gonna paste it here, boom. Now we're gonna hit save, and that is it for this part, okay? So now this code is going to be tracking page views on this theme. So that's step one. However, we also want to track sales. So what we wanna do is let's go to exit. We're gonna click on settings. We're gonna go to checkout. We're gonna scroll all the way down. And over here, we're gonna be adding a code to the order status page. Now, they don't suggest it. They suggest doing it using the automatic method. However, not always possible to do that. So we're going to add the code here. However, there is one small addition we need to add to the code, because this time we want to track sales, not just page views, right? So that's where this page comes in, conversion tracking. Like I said, I'm going to link this page in the description of the video. So we're going to scroll down. We're going to copy this part here because this is what's going to track the purchase. I'm going to Control C to copy it. And we're gonna place it right after the page view because we want to track the page, but then we also want to track the purchase. So here's the event, it's a purchase, and this is the currency you can change, and this is the value. So depending on whatever your currency is, if you're Canadian dollars, for example, you would just change that to CAD. Depending on the value, let's say for every sale, it's $20. You would add that here. If you're not sure of your value, then you can just find the average. Like let's say you have many upsells, many downsells, many different product services. Just go in and take the average. So now this code, we're gonna copy it, come back here and add in here and click on save. And that should be it. Congratulations, you have successfully manually set up the Facebook pixel on your Shopify store. You could check this, or at least check the part where we added it in the code, by clicking on your online store, and you can inspect element and you can look at the code that way, or you could use an extension. I use an extension called Meta Pixel Helper on Chrome, and it's going to show you what sort of Facebook pixel you have here. And it says here, this is the pixel ID we have, ending in 7608. Let's go back and check if that's the one. 7608, this is the pixel, 7608, this is the one we're using. So that is correct. So this page, this theme, contains our pixel, which is the page view pixel. If you go in and you actually make the purchase, you should see another pixel, which will be the purchase pixel on that page as well. And that's how you would basically check it. And that is all. This is how you set up the Facebook Ads Pixel on your Shopify store manually. If you guys enjoy this content, I do invite you to check out my website at ivanmana.com, where I have a lot of free resources. And I also offer detailed, very, very detailed training courses so that you can create profitable campaigns and start making money online. And that is all for this video. Thank you for watching. I will see you in the next one.